Hi, Trade the Pool. Let's talk about hotkeys and the desktop trader evolution software. Hotkeys are great because, number one, they just offer a different user interface option. So the more options you have, that's always nice. You don't have to use the mouse for everything. You can, and that way you can also be kind of moving the mouse around doing one thing, and you can use the keys for another. They're great because they're a quick reference single function. So in most cars, you'll see cars returning to this now, even you got a physical button, right, for certain different functions, because if you're looking at the screen, the road or the screen, you don't want to be fumbling around looking for this or that function, right? You know where that button is by feel, you know where you put your keyboard, you know what button it is, and you can just do that. And there's a single button for a single function, so that reduces the cognitive load. The third thing is, because of the speed of that, you can then use that for scalping. It can be great for just quick in and out, or to quickly, you're waiting for something to happen, you go to execute, boom, hit the key. Now, the way that these are arranged in Trader Evolution, there are general hotkeys and there are specific hotkeys for specific panels and functions. So we're going to talk about these in turn. Now, the place to start is the manual. So we'll take a look at the user manual here. We look under Getting Started Hotkeys. There's a hotkeys section. And we'll see that at the beginning, they just kind of show the settings panel. And I'll show you here how you can get to that, just for reference. So I have Trader Evolution here. And I just go over to Settings. And up it pops. I'll show a little trick for that in a moment, but we'll go back to the manual there. We have here a general intro, and then we have all the different settings categories that there are for this. So I would encourage taking a peek through that. This is the best place to start. Just read through it, see what hotkey functions are available, and go from there. We're going to be talking about hotkeys in general. Some of the panels, as I said, do have their own functions. So, for example, on the scalper, how those work is more in more detail, better spoken about in that video. But a couple thoughts here. One is, some of the functions may not have hotkeys, right? It's just the choice of what these software developers have chosen to put hotkeys for and which ones they haven't. If you're coming from different software, maybe they made different choices. Now, we might be able to request that certain functions be added by the vendor. We do work with them, but, you know, frankly, it may just be that some things don't have hotkeys, and you need to find an alternative way to do that. But keep in mind, there are those multiple panels. There's like three or four different trading and order entry panels. So if one of them doesn't have the hotkey function you're looking for, take a look at the others, because they all have slightly different styles and they're optimized for slightly different types of trading. So it might be that if you look at a different trading panel, like if you were looking in the Super Dom, then you look at the scalper, it might have everything you're looking for and more. And the last thing I want to suggest is take a look also at the hot buttons. Now, those are operated with the mouse. You put them on the screen, but they sit in a consistent place. And you can just quickly, again, boom, boom, you just go for the one thing you know and click execute. So in some cases, those can be almost as fast. Let's go ahead and take a look here. We've got a few different categories. As I said, let's take a look at the manual. So we've got our general purpose hotkeys. These apply across the system. We have then the panels ones. Now these apply sort of across the board, but to the panel that you're in. And then there's a few sort of oddball ones, like the order entry panel is really more for popping up order entries, and that applies, for example, in chart panels. It's not about as much settings for order entry. So again, this is something where it's worthwhile to become familiar, to just read through it and just become familiar with the categories. Now, if I go into Trader Evolution here, see a couple things. So the first thing that's kind of fun, right? If I want to bring up the settings, there's an issue with the hotkeys one right now, so don't worry about that, but I can assign a key to bring up the settings panel. So now I can just bring that right up again. Just kind of nice. There's also different things. If I want to see the connections, right, then I can do this. And then whenever I want to bring up info on my connections, I can actually bring up an additional connection, I guess. No, I can disconnect. Don't do that. but let's see. So we'll look at some of these general purpose ones again, right? So I can bring up, now you'll see a couple things for bringing up a new chart panel, a new order entry panel. Those will really bring up sort of the default ones, like it'll bring up your default stock. There's better ways to do both of those. So I'll show that in a second. But if we go to panels, let's take a quick look there. We can see if we want to bring up the settings for any given panel, right? We can do that with just Control G here. So I can be in positions to bring up my position panel settings, watch list, Control G. There's the settings for that panel and often for that instance of that panel, right? So I can have two watch lists. You're going to have different settings. The hotkeys, though, are set across the board. So that's the thing to keep in mind. Your hotkey settings are just no matter what there. Now, if we look at some of the specific ones, right? Like I mentioned, in particular, opening up a chart order entry. So if I go to the order entry, this place order one, there seems something not quite there. I think this might be to execute the actual order that we have up. But if I go, if I want to just open up an order entry, buy or sell, I can set hotkeys for both of those. And then if I'm over here somewhere, right, that's going to just use my default stock, which you can set in the settings. But here in this chart, which is for GameStop in this example, you'll see it pops up an order entry panel just for this one. So that can be real handy. And some other good ones here. I can also do things in the chart. Like, for example, like I can toggle the grid. Now, keep in mind, there's a general panel setting for Control G. I can also set it here. So if I'm clicked in here, Control G hides, unhides the grid. But if I click out to here, actually not going to do it. Yeah, it conflicts. So just be aware of conflicts there. And let me see if there's some other great keys to include. But you can see all of these trading panels have their different hotkeys. So the other thing is, keep in mind that some of the settings will be, some of the functions will be similar. Oh, and you can close all positions here. So that's another one that's similar across the board. But I can set, like, for example, working quantities in scalper. And actually, no, but yeah, place buy and sell order with amount equal to existing position, right? That's in market depth. And here, cancel buy and sell orders closest to last price. So that's a function that's available in scalper, a function that's available in the matrix, and it's a function that is available in market depth, right? And those all have different hotkeys. So if you want, you can set that to be consistent between all of them. You don't have to, though. So just be aware, if you set it, if you just kind of scroll through naively and see a setting that looks right, you do need to see which category it's in. All right, and a couple other tips here. I would say watch out for interference, right? If you've got other hotkey software installed, for example, I have auto hotkey on my system, that can be really handy. Or even other brokerage software, Moomoo, for example, by default in its hotkeys, some of them will apply whether you're in Moomoo brokerage software or not. So just watch out for anything that might be fighting for your hotkeys. There is some software available that can tell you a little bit which hotkeys are taking effect. And the other thing is, just by process of elimination, you can close everything except Trader Evolution. Start it, and then slowly start running the other things that you tend to run and see when your hotkey stops working. Anyway, the best way is to try it yourself. Like I said, read the manual, go through it, get a sense of what's available, scroll through this, like collapse those settings sections, look at the different sections. And I would encourage you, this is one of those things that's great to do while you're working with the free trial account. So, you know, during those 14 days, you can get a sense of the hotkeys, find out if it's something you're comfortable working with, and set up your settings the way you like them. And that way there's no cost or risk associated with it. Or the other thing you can do is you can do it if you have several evals, maybe use the smaller one, or if you have one that's about to expire, but just, you know, and also try setting your positions to be kind of smaller if you're working on some of the order execution ones. All right, and also join us on Discord. Share which hotkey settings work for you. Share any that you're trying that aren't working as you expected, and potentially even, you know, if there's a hotkey that you'd like to see that isn't there or you think isn't there, ask us. It might be that it's in a different section, or it might be that that's something that we can request. Again, that'll be up to development prioritization and the vendor, but it would be good to know which hotkeys people are looking for. So please do share that with us. And yeah, stock and roll.